Richard Marsden's with me in the studio this morning from Synairgen. Richard, good to see you. Good
morning. Hi, how you doing?
Big news this morning here. Handing responsibility for your fibrosis treatment program to Pharmaxis. First off, tell us a bit more about the deal here.
Yeah, so we've been working with Pharmaxis for a little over 2 years. And when we started the collaboration, it was very focused on lung disease, a really serious lung disease called IPF. And LOXL2 is an enzyme which is implicated in the fibrotic process in that disease. When we signed the agreement, we recognised, as did Pharmaxis, that other fibrotic conditions could emerge as perhaps more dominant indications to chase than the quite rare disease that we're very focused on, called IPF. And what has indeed happened over the last couple of years is the big pharma companies that we interact with have become super excited about moving this sort of asset into NASH. And that moves it away from our area of expertise and moves it much more towards Pharmaxis's area of expertise. Now, to meet the demands of the big pharma companies and to land a really good deal, we've got to do more work. And what we're doing now is saying to Pharmaxis, right, here we go, we've done this work together, we've produced some really good data together, and we've got now two compounds into phase 1 clinical trials, but it's better that you carry on with it and do whatever you need to do to get a really good deal. And in return, they're giving us £5 million of cash, and we've got a 17% interest in whatever transaction fees they get from a partner one day. So that would be upfront payments, milestone payments, and royalties.
And that 17%, just to be clear, it doesn't cover the partnership agreement solely with lung fibrosis.
Correct. It doesn't. It's for any indication. So what we'd expect now is that Pharmaxis will continue to work on the asset, complete the phase 1 clinical trials, and at that stage look for a partner, or maybe carry on and do a phase 2 trial and look for a partner. So we need to sort of gift Pharmaxis that right to chase down the best possible deal. That deal I would expect to be multiple compounds in multiple indications, and it'd be a very, very big transaction.
A big transaction and a huge market here.
Yeah.
So on the face of it, this is a stonking great deal for Synairgen.
But it's good for both companies. You know, it's great for us because we get £5 million of cash and this interest in the program going forwards. And, you know, there's plenty we can be getting on with £5 million of cash.
Speaking of which, what are the plans?
Well, we've got a program in COPD, so inhaled interferon beta, which is an antiviral, designed to help COPD patients, which is chronic bronchitis and emphysema patients, when they get colds and flu infections, because it really hits their chest. So we want to progress that into a phase 2 clinical trial and complete that next year. We've also always keen to look at other opportunities, and what we've done with this transaction with Pharmaxis over a space just over 2 years, we spent about £3 million using our technology and our approach, so using our models of human lung disease to add value to something. This time it was the right time to say, right, we're not going to carry on, we'll let you carry on with it. But it just shows you the power of the models and our approach, and, you know, we're getting £5 million back, an interest in the program going forward, and there are more opportunities out there.
Indeed, and of course, good to see in early trades this morning. I think Synairgen's share price up 70-odd%. So pleasing to see the market recognises the significance of this deal.
Yeah, no, pleased with that.
And you're pleased with 2017, how it's been?
Yeah, it's been an interesting year because we had the interferon beta asset handed back to us from AstraZeneca because they didn't get the data they wanted in asthma. We've seen some good features in that data set, and we're very keen, as I said before, to go into COPD.
Richard, good to see you as always. Thanks very much.
Thank you.